Hello and welcome to day 57 of 100 Days of Happy. I wanted to go back to a blog post I wrote a long time ago about butterflies and more about metamorphosis transformation. And so this one's going to be a little bit longer than usual, but with us all going through so much transformation around planet, whether it's good or bad, I just wanted to really focus in on what I wrote then and how you can consider the process you're going through, the changes, the transformation, the struggles that help us turn into beautiful butterflies. So this is from the blog. Yesterday, I began my morning walk surrounded by butterflies and sunshine, lots of butterflies. Different colours, different sizes of butterflies, all so very beautiful and unique in their own way, dancing and twirling around me for the whole of my walk. I took a couple of pictures because it fascinated me that there were so many and so many different varieties. Butterflies have a number of symbolic meanings, from change and transformation to the spirits of loved ones, to a reminder to change, through to this lovely meaning. There is a Native American legend that says, if you have a secret wish, capture a butterfly and whisper your wish to it. Since butterflies cannot speak, your secret is ever safe in their keeping. Release the butterfly and it will carry your wish to the Great Spirit, who alone knows the thoughts of butterflies. By setting the butterfly free, you are helping to restore the balance of nature, and your wish will surely be granted. This sounds an absolutely wonderful thing to do. The change and transformation of butterflies fascinates me. It's a miraculous process and one so metaphorical with our own evolution as humans, and I think so at this time. Like butterflies, we move through different growth stages in life, and I guess there's always comes that stage where you're breaking out of the cocoon. I think for some of us, we feel the security we've created of our own cocoon, our comfort zone, and we want to stay there. Like the pupa, we believe we won't survive if our chrysalis is broken. And yet there's a time for metamorphosis and change, and resisting only restricts and damages us and causes us suffering. Yet some of us still cling on, irrespective of the hurt we do to ourselves. We're captured by the fear of the unknown. To flow and go with life sees us emerging from the struggles as a beautiful creature in our true colours. When you're faced with a cocoon, remember it's a gross process and this too shall pass. Write a description of the person you want to show up as in the world, and know that every event, challenge and opportunity is building your skills towards that goal, towards that person. If there's a hint of unique, strong or power in your description, recognize the muscle and wing building opportunities that are being provided. So what stage of evolution are you at? I would guess we're all pretty much breaking out of the cocoon. What action would help you move beyond your cocoon, knowing you will emerge as beautiful as the butterfly in all its glory? Take time to visualize you beyond the chrysalis, the new you, you as your butterfly self. Feel the freedom as you soar and dance. I hope this helps someone out there today who may be stuck in the struggle, to know that this is you breaking out of the cocoon. This is your opportunity to create the new you. What are the lessons you're learning at this moment in time? Can you sit in your resistance, in the tension, and recognize the lesson and the blessing? I hope this helps someone today. Have an amazing evening, and I'll see you again tomorrow.